Good morning, evening, afternoon, everybody. We're back just in time for the meteor to start to go south of the city. We'll check out what kind of damage we've done. Look on the hot right here. So, my intentions for this episode, micro lag there, still loading in, I believe, part of that. There's all kinds of people that want to disappear. The last episode, we got hydrogen taken care of, and we got communications taken care of. Well, for right now, comms are working between me and the ship. Solar panels are up. But no fear of running out of uranium anytime soon. With all the uranium I mined from underneath the boat here, there's something like 2K. Million? Yeah, 2.4K. 24. 100 kilograms. Makes me curious if I can do something. Possibly wanted to dig out some finished stuff. Well, top one is more just an attachment to the signal drop from them. So what I'm thinking is save on refilling all the time. I need more uranium anytime soon. It's making me a hit. So what I need to think about is better resource providing and management. Coming up with ideas on. We've got a lot of resources here still processing. Carbon, nickel, uranium. Final stage of the uranium I mined last time. I picked up some nickel and some carbon. I think I definitely need to get some more. Let's see, if I got plenty of iron. I have no cobalt. I definitely need some cobalt. Well, I got a little bit. I got 234 cobalt. Let's cut these back on. Let's see. Three carbon, calcium, iron. Nickel, copper. Oh, well. Favorite jetpack for this kind of stuff. Building ladder. Down in the holes. So, those little micro lags right there are much less intense with air tightness off. So, I have turned off the pressurization of rooms, even though I know how it's going to be airtight. be an issue right now with the performance of the game, especially for me. Let's see if I only have this much. Have to upgrade soon. I'm gonna go for the new motherboard. Should fix most of my issues. Maybe If you'll see that, that's Build Vision. That mod allows you to look at individual settings and plots directly without having to go through the control panel. It's a very nice mod. I like it. It's done well. It doesn't allow you to do much functions without having to go to sit and see or find the control panel inside the box here. Very interesting. This mod has quite a few refineries. I was looking through the construction list, and I'm going to have to get a bunch of material together. But in order to refine faster, you see I'm starting to get a lot of filled up in here of materials, and I need to think about how to get more out of what I'm doing. So over there, I need more small steel tubes. Converters, small steel tubes, we'll take those units, we'll take the construction problems. I don't think I'm moving the steel plate a couple times. I think that's it. I don't think I'm moving. Welder. Some other tools. What we have here, not really, we just do the hand welder, maybe. We got neodymium, nickel, iron, copper, and carbon, carbon, and copper. Got a little bit of chlorine, got some cadmium in there. Try to make us some things. Similar, there are different assemblers as well to do different things, electronics, chemicals, etc. And I haven't tested all of them or looked through any of them yet to see what all they do, but we're going to. We're going to build a platform for refining materials, building proper tools. A little bit of a drill here. Thank you. That doesn't seem normal to me, but maybe you guys can tell me. But you see how those are highlighted? So here? Interesting. Now, yeah, we're gonna have a ladder climbing out of here. Getting in the cobalt. One of the things I realized the other day is that the entire intro to this mod is missing because of the sound issues I had on the first episode. So basically, a mod developer by the name of Geneticus on the Keen Software House forums has designed this mod as kind of a expansion to the base game that will have a tiered technology creation, and it does so through modified components, modified blocks, and of course, as you can see, lots of modified ores and materials. Tungsten, carbon, neodymium, uranium, phosphorus, tetrachloride amino acids, magnesium, tungsten, calcium, nickel, sulfur, carbon, all the normal plus some. And each piece has a couple of new things here and there to craft them. Like each block has a few new components, and those new components require some of these new materials. So you modified the base very much to give quite a bit of development process. Like there's some stages to it, which seems really cool. Let's test out our ladder. Running up the ladder. You can sprint on these ladders, which is a very nice feature of this mod. This makes getting up and in and out of your mine a lot easier. Why ladders or elevators are not in the base game, I never understood, but... potassium, silicon, aluminum. Cobalt. the signals with the antenna going definitely but what we've got here is we've got a lot of stuff that we need to process, but we only have the one side. We're getting some cobalt together. We're going to need cobalt. We're going to need cobalt. So I need fences. What we need is ammo containers and a turret. So, got some magnesium powder, got some potassium, got some nitrogen, phosphorus, sulfur, carbon, lead, copper, zinc. But it seems a little more realistic that you require more elements to create certain things, especially bullets. Some of you may or may not like this feature. Some may seem like too much to gather, craft, but I like the idea that you can't step through the technology super fast. His idea is also that you have to build so many blocks of a certain type, or so many blocks in general before you can access the next level of tier technology. I do not believe that any of that is implemented. I believe that's future progression. If you look in the description, I'll link the mods again in this one, and I'll also link the forum. It's linked in the first one as well. You can check out the whole thread on the forums and read up on it and see what the plans are. He's still in kind of a maintenance mode right now. It's the last update from him, but he has no plan to drop the large hydrogen injector. Definitely need to make some ammunition, magnesium, silver, nickel, and iron. And then, looking at blocks. Iron, nickel, neodymium, copper, silicon wafer, and gold ingots. So, let's go walk with this chip. There'll be motors in the future. Lots and lots of motors. I have to go walk the piston and clarity command. Wheel. What we need is we need something defensive against the meteors. I'm thinking I'll build a small storage container on a small little platform and a conveyor and a turret. Set to target meteors. I will have to still go investigate this hillside, see if there was any platinum in that drop. I have found it once or twice before in meteor drops. So we've got to find each of these holes. That looks like the tungsten. I think this is tungsten, world save. Never much tungsten. You know, that's that. Okay. Lithium. This one. several, there's at least seven of those things here. Further up the hill here, maybe. Rendering so rough sometimes, and if you don't really see it right away, you can get a little closer. It's a hard time to do. Interesting. There's some voxel generation that's a little weird. But, and it's a piece of stone weighing 405. No, organic mulch. Organic mulch, huh? Interesting. What that'll give us. Alright, so let's move back before we run out of hydrogen. I think we're okay right now, 45%. And we just repeat it. Hydrogen cannot get too fast. Alright, so let's put all this stuff on here. We need a gas compressor, I believe. I think that's one of the next steps that I need to build something to pull all the ice and the gas and everything off of the refinery. Grab a grinder and open up the side of the ship. Don't want to cut too much of that. Might drop the motor. Might still want to move this thing or something. But here's a tube coming out here. So let's get in our conveyor box. Sorter just in case. Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna need a sorter with this mod. I throw a connector on it for later use. These are specific types of rotors. So these are some mod and hinge conveyors. We can move it a little bit. Anyway, here we go. It's just been too. Let's take this long. Let's see what I can do. proper. Iron, nickel, 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 copper. Ah, where's on this one? This is not. Not enough materials for that. Definitely gotta make plastic coating supplies. Look at oxygen, look at hydrogen. It's all being supplemented. Probably hear the cats and the collars rolling around as we're loading. Here we go. The game crashed and we had an issue with the sound or something, like a meter phone came in and then suddenly the game started freaking out. It crashed. I'm loading back in now. Oh, what? Pardon my French. What in the world? What is that? Wow, my medical room and everything destroyed, dude. Six kilometers away. If we can make it, dude. There's a lot of resources there. And look at the skybox. Well, that was crazy. We were in the air or something. I wish I could have had an outside view of that. And that's a lot of resources over there. We got another lander now. I think I had it turned off. I mean, stuff should, well, even if the ship pieces are gone, stuff should still be on the ground. We can make it over there, I hope. At least some of it will be. Oh, 90 kilometers to go. 54 minutes of time. I'm gonna do this. I got the 250 meters per second speed mod. It's just my personal taste, so I don't really need it much faster than that. It's hard to control some vehicles. That was insane. That's crazy. So it loaded in when I was on the other side of the refinery, cutting out those blocks. What's the last say? And when I come in, I saw the ice moving. and I don't know why, but for some reason we were in the air, flying back towards the ground, sideways, like the cloud into the ground, front end first, like as far as I could. Yeah, the refinery corner is right here. No, the refinery corner is back here, so it's on its back. I mean, I've seen some crazy boats. I've seen things explode and motors. We got my body location and a couple of GPS markers over there. So, uranium, silver, sodium. We can get our speed. It's gonna be a little trip. Well, I wasn't planning on this episode, but I do want to stay close to the moon with my setup, so I'm gonna try to get this vehicle back over there. Back down to 43 minutes, 44 minutes. It's gonna modify as I use the thrusters. But I would much rather travel this 80 kilometers now than have to travel it from out of the side of the gravity well. I don't know, we're gonna work on something. Man, that's crazy. I was totally planning on setting up a platform and defenses against the meteor storm. But it looks like we're going to try to land another lander. In the world caused that? You'll think it was that ladder going down from the base of it. That could have meant something. The ladder glitched and launched me into the air. The ladder glitching could have been what? I don't know. But it didn't happen before, and then it just happened. That's so weird. Well, let's not attach a ladder to the bottom of our ship. 68. I'm using my big thrusters kind of as forward thrust by tilting the front nose way down. Way down. We'll make pretty good time like this. Pretty good overview of the land around the place again. And maybe it'll be daytime. It was nighttime when I first came in and we first set up. So, I'm sure that was the ladder. Couldn't have been much else. Now, I do know this thing is running on the batteries right now pretty much. The way they designed this lander is batteries are in the primary juice because it's a small reactor overloads on this new thruster. You can use it forward and up at the same time to keep moving forward. It kind of will overload you and it'll fall out of the sky. So the batteries are necessary. Trying to use the higher altitude, but the problem is the atmospheric engine will start losing power at night. So we're going to get stuck right in between 5,000 and cruising a low orbit chicken planet out. As you can call it, low orbit. We're already 47. That's a kilometer every 4 seconds, according to this. It's 4 or 5 seconds, maybe 6 seconds. We're not actually looking directly at it. But should still have a little daylight when we get over here. Hope there's some of that uranium and stuff there. Wow, I cannot believe that, dude. bet most of my components are gone. Looks like we're going to be building a mining station. So we're going to have to rebuild. And we do have some components here, but I was in the process of crafting this stuff. Still have my helmet on. 32 kilometers of closing. Big lake here on the left. This hill to my left is the one I scouted the first time. I flew over this hill over here and decided that I wanted to launch this hill. The moon was right there. So, it was pretty dark that night when I flew in here. I flew over the top of that hill. I know there's gold up there somewhere on that hill. I'll find anything else. And I am getting some minute amounts from stone and ice and stuff, frozen stuff. Should be most of that stuff left here. We've got a body location, some primary things. There's also several GPS signals. Pieces of it down there. I'm not sure what that has. What the hell happened to it? That's pretty crazy. Is that a meteor hitting me? Plenty of resources left on this one. Hopefully, we can ship it. Wow. It's like solar panels survived. The thing just like laying at the end of my body. No, there's some broken pieces here as well. Something about this planet, maybe, is a little glitchy with his mods. I mean, we'll see. We're gonna continue. We're not gonna let it stop us. Yay for the save. Man, that was crazy. Like all of the systems on the ship are going at fucking at one time. Huh. Oh, 2.4k uranium, yay! Found uranium. That's important piece. Mine more of the telescope. Silver, calcium, carbon, sodium. We got another lander, we got extra components, and I've saved most of the materials. I think. Craziest explosion like that ever. That was pretty crazy. So, I had a lander one time, and I'm sure some of you may know of the landing gear, but your landing gear locks to the planet, and you release it. Sometimes, your lander, or whatever vehicle may be, will just start floating and head to space. Despite gravity, despite inertial dampeners, despite thrusters, it's going to space. All by itself. I've seen it happen 2 or 3 times. So, I try not to use the lock feature when I'm on the planet. I need it to make it flat. Take this steel, start my platform. Maybe. Ouch. No. Oh crap. Boom! Wow. That's getting too close. It's time to build a platform. I'll rest on the stack across this way. Some more methane hydrochlorides. Mercury, no, maybe calcium. No. I didn't save any hydrogen bottles out of that. My body was gone. There's a hydrogen bottle I had on me was gone, but there's a hydrogen evaporator, I think, still attached to that conveyor. So we may save some bottle, at least one bottle. And we got two more on this one. we ought to be good. That's good. That's good. No med bay left. All of that's fine. That's great. Everything's gone. Assembler. Cargo container.
Oh, yeah. Meteor storm inbound.
Shoot, that will look like a place. Please, no. Armageddon out here, people. Are they serious with this right here? Oh, it's crazy. Wow. Alright. Time for the platform. Rare. Sorry for the apologies in the video. We'll be fixing it soon. We're going through all these liquids and get some stuff, some movement, get some extra ice out. Organic hydrocarbons is frozen. I'm assuming that this plaf, you get ice from it. Well, the chemical process to do that, you're going to get some things from other things when you process it. So I like that. It's really effective to the breaking down the material. Because when you refine materials, you don't always just get the ingots, the melted material. you get all the junk too. You have to clean it up and do things with it. That's interesting. I like that a lot about this mod. I could probably have a lot of fun just mining and seeing what I'm getting every day. Same as do a pure stone run and gems mod and see how long it takes you to build anything using your stone. Stone and sandstone and things like that. I was thinking about adding one of those gravel processing mods for enrichment to get my materials, but I think I need gravel or something. So I'm going to wait and play some of this out before I do any more material editing mods. I'm already running the thorium reactor mod my tool is made. I may lock it to the ground until I destroy it. Alright, now we're doing ice. Let's do this lithium. A lot of the stuff I had on me. Thank you. Copper plates. Lots to do because of the ammunition. Ooh, lots of ammunition. Now, question is do I cut short here and do that next episode? Or do I run on through and split it two episodes? I need to mine a good bit. make this thing. Nitrogen, phosphorus, sulfur, potassium, magnesium, zinc, lead, and carbon. Carbon looks like the main thing I have. There's a lot more than that. Zinc, potassium, sulfur, lead. Zinc, potassium, sulfur, and lead. Sulfur, zinc, carbon, sulfur, zinc, and lead. Alright, so. There's lead over here by the gold museum. Sulfur is where the lead level is produced. So, let's make ourselves. Thank you. long cover tree, large cover trees, and fire. Brief interruption, sorry about that. More small cup of tubes. Wow. Alright, seems I've got some encoding overload here. To this game is freaking me out. I don't know what's causing issues here. Sulfur. I could easily miss one of these laying on the floor. Oh, with the colors of the floor and everything looking the same as what it's sitting in. And it looks very well done. Man, that's camouflage.
Inventory full. Inventory full.
Thank you. gonna get this new demo and get some tools made. And then we're gonna do a break in the episodes. And we'll come back for the next episode and get my ammunition ready. Hopefully in the same night.
Meteor storm inbound.
I'm under the impression that I was in the version of the sun. Right now, I'm gonna have to have a mining vehicle. I was gonna build a scout vehicle to find the ore and go chase it down with the remote control, but they're all around me. With the antenna, I can see 90% of them. So, the thought about it during the break last time that I should spend the resources more on building a ship rather than. A drone. So I'm gonna build a drone machine too. That'll probably be what we're doing this episode of the to get more resources. But I need to get this turret built. That was the object of this particular episode, to defend the base. Seems like meteor is the problem. Before we get destroyed, all this gold. happening out there. I think I'm gonna have an ant hill or a tunnel or something to use this lake before I'm done. This should be enough lead to get us started on some ammo.
Storm inbound.
Another one? Wow. This is normal. I'm just like freaking on the dead. The apocalypse is upon us. That's Jeez, 1, 2, 3. Well, at least they're not aiming very well. Cancel that one. Sulfur, zinc, lead. Get the sulfur, get our ammunition in our turret. This one you should be good for the one episode. Y'all let me know, because I can tell with the all these resources this can be tedious, especially hand drilling. I'm gonna have to get the machine built. That's probably the next step. It's building a drill ship. So next episode, that's what we'll start on, building machine to get all these resources. I've got a pretty good idea of what I'm going to do, but I just don't know if I've got enough to get done. So there may still be some hand drilling. If y'all don't like all the drilling, I can do some editing, cut some of it out. But I tend to talk a lot during those times as well about what I'm going to do and what's going on with mod. What the hell? I just died for no reason. Under the ground. What is this nobody medical room? Is that a cargo ship or something? I can spawn them, I just don't know where it is. Kinda looks like it might be on the moon. If it's on the moon, that might be a goal. Let's see what's there. Where's my body locations? So I turn around and start picking up this stuff. And suddenly I was dead. And of course, there's no body. At least none of my stuff off of my body. And of course, the damage. That was pretty weird. I think I just lost those tools. Pardon my friend. That's one glitch I don't like about this game. Being underground and dying and your backpack disappearing through the ground. It's never be seen.
Meteor storm inbound.
I died from sulfur poisoning. Alright, let's get some of the sulfur. Optical illusions in the shadows. Another one coming. This time they're coming from space. This space. World there. Three over here. And this place is going to be peppered. We could turn those off at some point. I'm just hoping I might get some platinum out of them. I'll have to go around and bank out. Might be one person who could do the situation. Go check the areas out. Alright, so let's get this little bit of sulfur running. There's a stone in there. There's tools just going in here. Because if there's no power and there's no oxygen on the moon, or whatever that is, I'm going to be screwed. So, I want to take a vessel to the moon and investigate what that might be. So, we're going to have to do some major construction, which means we need a vessel. So, at this point right here, we have just finished making 20 rounds for our 20 magazine boxes, ammo boxes, or whatever. For our cleric, we have established a little bit of something of a platform here, and we still need to clean up that lander. Or maybe what I do as soon as I get back is clean up the lander. We're out of hydrogen. So, what? Dude? 25 by 184. Can't convey without power. Power. Alright, so it does. I don't know what I was thinking. Can't put a battery in it. We've got to see if it does not react to components. And we're gonna run out of there. Maybe not. Ah, whatever we're gonna do. Alright. Watch that welder and everything. Small damage. Get it. Power this. 25 computers, 6 motors, 25 wire screws. Craft components washed up to your middle grills to put the components to. can say it's the game, but the cursor is still moving and the recording is still good. The game spikes real high in CPU at the best times. And we still haven't quite figured out why it does that. We got plenty of uranium, so we just need to drop us a reactor on here. That's why I wanted that to make it be something that I forgot large groups. And then the group will have. Alright, yeah, I think this is going to be the end of this night. I think it's dysfunctional. Definitely didn't call it. We want to make over time. We got it online. I wish we could take my helmet off when I come back to do it. Voila. We get out. Sucking four of them as soon as we can with them. Nice. 7, 13, yes, and good. I didn't think that was working enough. It was soft early on. Alright. We've got a med bay on the lander just in case anything weird happens. I'm going to do something I hardly ever do because I'm just going to destroy this lander anyway. And I'm going to lock the landing gear in the lander. Until we grind it down. So. That's what we're going to call it, right here. Episode 2 of Gen 1. We'll see everybody next time. Thank you.